one mic. One mic. All I need is one mic. That's all I ever needed in this world. Fuck cash. All I need is one mic. Fuck the cars, the jewelry. All I need is one mic. Spread my voice to the whole world.
I don't know if y'all can hear me. So anyway, I just wanted to start recording because I've been having a lot on my mind. Oh yeah, this is Mary T. Lavelle with Off the Record. And with everything that's going down as far as the protests and stuff like that, I just thought that I could, like how I felt, I wanted to speak out about how I felt about it. Because I consider myself a revolutionary only in the simple sense that I do see that we need change and that the change needs to come. But the issue is that people don't know how they need how to change. People are so set in their ways. And so the situation that we're going through now with the protests that are going on, I have a lot of feelings towards that because of the simple fact that the rest of the world, I've already mentioned this before, the rest of the world is waiting on the United States to get their shit together because they've relied on us. The United States flag did used to stand for something. It did used to stand for freedom. It did used to stand for, you know, not in freedom, not in the sense of how they gave it to us. That's not freedom. What it stood for is the strength behind it, the fight for the independence. And that's what we're going through now is a fight for independence. But the simple fact is the U.S. doesn't even realize that they're dependent because we're that lucky. The rest of the world now is waiting on us to get our shit together. And this protest that's going on around the states now, I don't think this is the revolution that people pretend that it is. Because of the simple fact that we already know what they do to us. We already know about the brutality that's been put on black and brown bodies, especially black bodies. And if you're paying attention, the U.S. should have been mad a long ass time ago. Because what's happening to us now has been happening around the rest of the world for a long time now. People are going through struggles. Not to say that our struggle doesn't matter. Our struggle does matter because we need to pay attention to the direction that we're going in if we continue to just sit back and be complicit. But there are people out there that are suffering and don't have what we have right now, which is that opportunity to speak out to without being shot in the mouth for it. Because around the world, some people can't do that. And with that freedom that we have, we are the ones who live behind these, who say we live by these standards and these morals, that we respect the human body, that we respect the free spirit, that we respect independence. We should be speaking out for our brothers and sisters who are suffering now, who have been suffering for a long time, who are continuing to suffer, who are waiting for somebody, anybody to stand up and speak for them. Because they can't speak for themselves in the situation that they've been put in, not only by the United States, but by France, by Russia, by China, by all these global powers, whose people are rich off of what they do to other countries. And the fucked up thing is, I'm a patriot to the fucking fullest. You can't fucking tell me shit. I believe in my country. I believe in where I'm from because in this lifetime, it's all I know. But I also realize that we're not only from this soil. We were birthed from a motherland. And it's not the one that they would have you believe. It's the one that they're now currently raping and tearing apart. And we gotta realize that once you have something you believe in, like I believe in the people of the United States, I believe in them, I know where my original home is. A lot of people don't, so I'm lucky in that sense. I know where my original home is, and I don't have to. I didn't have to look it up in paper. I didn't have to send them my DNA and say, "Tell me where I'm from." I know where I'm from. And that's why I'm saying that we should be caring about every single person on this planet. So the protests that are going out there right now, they want you to believe that it's for George Floyd, that it's for the black bodies that the police have attacked, have killed, for the sacrifices that they made to get us to this point. And those weren't sacrifices that we chose. Those are just options they gave us. And now they're telling you you need to be upset about it when you should have been upset. You should have fucking been upset. You should have been out there. And I know it's bullshit that's what's going on now, and I'm going to say it. It's fucking bullshit. This protesting shit, y'all think y'all doing this is fucking bullshit. I've been out there. Y'all don't know what the fuck y'all doing. Y'all don't know where y'all going next. And they setting you up. You out there with your signs. Even if you think you peaceful protesting, you part of the goddamn problem too. You out there with your signs now. You out there with your chants saying you want them to hear your voices. They been heard you. They're not listening. They been heard you and they're not listening. But you think you got freedom. When they controlling the freedom you got. And you don't even realize it. They tell you who to be angry at. They tell you when to get upset, when to go mad, when to get out there and get in the streets. They tell you when. Instead of you realizing the shit that you're being manipulated. And that's fucked up to say because I believe in my black community. I know we have always been targeted. Around the world, we have always been targeted. We've never been in a situation where they let us be who we are, the magic that we are. They never let us do that. No matter where we go on this planet. So you should have been mad. And I'm not talking about mad in the sense of going down there, burning shit down, screaming at the top of your lungs, hoping that somebody in the void hears you when you just need to listen to yourself. And I've been wondering, because I'm like, usually I'm out there, front lines, front and center, ready to take this shit, but I know bullshit when I see it. About to put my body on the front lines when y'all don't even know what the fuck you fighting for. You don't even know who your enemy is. So you go out there in these protests and you fight and you say, you fighting for this right. And then what? What if they came up to you? What if Trump came up to you today and said, I hear you. What next? How can I help you? What would you tell them? I don't know, just fix it. Or would you try to find a way to fix it? Do we have plans? Do we have plans? Because we realize now that our leaders, we can hand them a whole packet of answers and they're not going to read it. So why then aren't we taking those packets, those answers, and applying them for ourselves instead of waiting on somebody else to do it? We're supposed to be self-made. This is the land of opportunities and dreams, baby. It was built on our sweat, built on our blood, built on our backs. And we still let them take control over our bodies. This planet is our body and y'all are destroying it. I just really think that if y'all gonna do the protest thing, you at least should do it right. So let's just say, because y'all not hearing me anyway, so y'all gonna be out there, y'all gonna be mad, y'all probably gonna be like, you a coon, this and this and that, like I don't fucking know. But go ahead, do exactly what they want you to do. Don't listen. But at least listen to this, because if you are gonna protest, I support free will. I can't force anybody to do a goddamn thing. I can't even force you to listen to this right now. But if you are going to go out there, you are going to protest, if you're going to ask for change this way, you got to know what you're doing. And I'm telling you, them peaceful signs, even if you think you're being peaceful, you fucking it up too, because that ain't how we're going to get where we're going. If you're out there looting, you fucking up too, because that ain't how we're going to get where we're going. We need to plan, we need to move, and we need to move like a fucking military, the way that they're going to send them after us, the way that they've been sending them around the world. So if you out there and you like, this is ours, you out there fighting, stop attacking black bodies, all right, black bodies, then let's pick them up, let's clean them up off the street then. Can't just walk by them, you gotta clean them up off the street. Y'all out there protesting for George Floyd and y'all want the cops arrested, right? The three cops that sit around and watched homeboy murder him. What about the people who was recording that shit? I ain't hear nobody asking for their arrest because they were complicit too. They were a part of that too. Motherfuckers conspired to kill that man. And the motherfuckers who you thought was the people who were giving you the information and saying, oh no, don't do that to him, they ain't do shit to help him. Oh, were they scared? Let's say they were scared. Oh, those are armed officers. So the fuck what? There's enough motherfuckers on the street seeing something going, doing wrong. It don't matter how many guns they dropped in your lap. You should help somebody. But everybody swear they tough until the moment happens. And this ain't the moment. This ain't the movement. Y'all kidding yourselves. Y'all don't know what the fuck you fighting for. And that's exactly why we gonna fail. We should be building. If you gonna do this shit for real, and you gonna go out there, and you gonna start looting, you better take that building, you better remake that building into something that's a black business. That's something that we can sustain ourselves with instead of just taking and taking and taking and taking and not giving shit back to where you came from. Mad at Target. Target's a big corporation. All right, go take their building. You saying that this is built on our sweat, our blood, our backs, our tears. So take that shit back. Take it back and we can just... We can rebuild this whole thing because we already doing it for free, even though they say they're paying you, but you've been working for the corporation, working for yourselves, and they telling you the value of it. And you don't even realize that you don't need to cut out the third man then. Cut out the third man. We don't need the corporation. We could just do it ourselves like we've been doing it, but under their rules, their restrictions. And so now you want to say you protest and you're going for a revolution. So go take them buildings back and make them ours. Really make them ours. That's what I'm saying, babe. I was calling them like, y'all barricade yourselves into these buildings. These buildings that you claim belong to us. These buildings that have been built on our backs. Take this shit back. You got to barricade them. Keep them out of them. But you can still take those resources and redistribute them out to the community the way that you want to. We got to keep sustaining ourselves some way if we're going to do this. Being on the streets yelling and screaming about it ain't going to help. So if we really going to go to war with motherfuckers, then let's go to fucking war. But y'all not ready for that. You ain't never seen war. On a civil war? Who fought that? We did. And then we went and laid. We died for these motherfuckers. And wait and laid right back in the graves they dug for us. Instead of taking the opportunity that we've been given. And they gave us a huge opportunity. They gave us a huge fucking opportunity because they put this shit right on top of the coronavirus where they had businesses shut down anyway, where we have masks over our face so we can protect our identities and do what we need to do and move quickly. And the buildings are already shut down, so you know there ain't nobody really in there waiting for them except for the police now because they know y'all out there. When you could have been took those buildings back. Oh, you was mad that your favorite grocery store was closed? You should have went and took that shit back. Open it up. It belonged to us anyway, right? Who are they to tell us? But y'all not ready to do that, right? Because they not going to just let us do it. I'm telling you, they not just going to let us do it. It ain't going to be easy. But if y'all motherfuckers really saying y'all want to go to war, then let's go to war then. Let's go to war. Y'all ain't going to war now. Cause y'all don't even have no plan. How the fuck I'm gonna go hang out with y'all and y'all ain't got no goddamn plan. Y'all just out there. Y'all think y'all know what y'all fighting for. But why we just getting here? If you was really ready, what changed? Because I've been arguing with motherfuckers on Twitter all day. If you really going to be out there like, yeah, this is for the people. This is for the people. Listen to this. They playing. They got people out there donating for bail. That sounds great, right? They donating for bail. Get niggas out. That's sitting there telling niggas, we'll pay you to go get arrested. But where we are when y'all could have been paying us when we were struggling? Y'all could have been paying us for housing. Y'all could have been paying us when we needed to come up, when we needed to open up our small businesses. Y'all could have been paying us then. Because apparently you was just sitting on the money. Well, why was you helping then? But you want to help now because they tell us now is the time to riot. Now is the time you can get upset. It's okay. Because it's a setup. I know bullshit when I see it. But if y'all gonna really do it, if y'all really out there, if y'all really fighting for what y'all say y'all fighting for, then y'all need to take back what's yours. Leaders aren't listening anymore. They haven't been listening. They haven't been listening for a long time. They ain't been listening. So now you think it's the time for us to fucking... Well, apparently y'all pick now, because I didn't think y'all... I honestly don't think y'all ready for a revolution. Y'all motherfuckers not ready. But if y'all gonna sit there and say this is it, alright. So let's see what you got. How you gonna rebuild these communities? In all the rioting, has anybody asked to open up schools again? We should have been mad about the amount of bodies it took to get to this point. We should have been mad. You got your ancestors screaming down your back and you don't even see it. Man, the resources are out there too. So I don't want to hear bullshit about what we ain't got. Motherfuckers always asking for money, always asking for donations, talking about revolution. Revolution don't need donations. No revolution needs a donation. Because the resources are already there. So if they're asking you for money, they're not asking you for the right things. But since y'all chose now to want to try to be, y'all ain't even woke. Y'all just living in a fever dream. And I'm not saying to go jump on any bandwagons. You ain't got to believe what I say. You just got to trust in yourself. You got to start taking care of yourself. We got to start... You don't owe loyalty to anyone but yourself. You don't owe integrity to anyone but yourself. So I'm not even asking you to listen to me for my sake. It's for your own sake. And then even you get to choose then. You ain't got to listen. Because that's the freedom of being alive. It's like you get a choice. But I hope you listen to yourself, because deep down we forgot where our magic came from and we stopped listening to that. We stopped listening to ourselves. And that's because our bodies have been so poisoned and so infected. And it's like, you got to take care of you first before you can take care of anybody else. Don't have them sit you behind this idea that you love only exists with another person or love only exists. You got to love yourself first. And you got to see your own blessings. And then by doing that, people don't realize once they prosper, the whole entire world goes with them. Because once you understand your place in life, once you understand your light, you ain't got no reason to be jealous of or damn try to dim anybody else's. And then by doing that, you can illuminate the whole world. Because once everybody starts believing in and trusting in themselves, you can light up the whole world. But you have to take care of yourself first. You got to take care of your body. You got to take care of your mind. You got to take care of your spirit. You're not taking care of your bodies now. Motherfuckers getting shot in the face with rubber bullets. I saw this girl on Twitter got shot in the face with rubber bullets, and people gonna call her a hero. Bitch, that's dumb. Don't put your body on the line like that. Protect yourself. Because your sacrifice is not going to be what fuels us forward. Sacrificing yourself isn't. The light that once your light goes dim, it's gone. Why would you let somebody take your light? And I'm not saying as in it's a death thing, because death ain't the end. I'm talking about in which you put your life towards. Because you put your light and your energy into everything. And so people are going to want you to use it for their effort. To lighten up their life. But you got to lighten up yourself first. You got to realize just how important you are. You got to realize just how much you matter. You got to start realizing that your body is a gift. And death isn't the end. It's not the end. But you've been given a gift each and every time you've opened your eyes, each and every time your spirit has re-enlightened itself. And you owe it to the God within you to take care of yourself. So the body that you've been gifted and you've been blessed with, you're not going to give it back the same way it was. You're going to give it back better. That's what you should be aiming to do. Give it back better. That means you have to start taking care of your body. You got to start taking care of yourself. You got to start eating right. Don't let them poison you with the food that they put out there. You can grow your own crops. We've been doing it. Y'all forget where y'all came from. Y'all forget that we the ones that put these motherfuckers in power. We the ones that built this world. And we built it because at some point we believed in ourselves. We knew our magic. They knew our magic too. That's why they try to profit off of it. And you're letting them. You're letting them profit off of your life. When you don't need, maybe, who's to put, they put, that means they put value on who you are. They put a price on who you are. So you don't know. So you think there's a limit. When you can shine in a whole damn full circle from this galaxy, from this universe, from this life to the next. They don't want you to know that though. But if you're going to be out there and you're going to, this is what you're choosing, take care of your mind, take care of your body, take care of your spirit. It's all a gift. And once you start doing that, then your light will shine where everybody else's and we'll start illuminating again. And we'll start brightening up the world again. But it starts with you and not the herd mentality that they put you in. They're going to tell you you're fighting for a revolution, but what you're really fighting for is their profit. And some people realize that, but not enough do. But if you're going to be out there, if you're going to be doing all this, take care of yourselves. Try to take the buildings. Keep those resources. The most important thing during a time like this, if you're going to try to go up against these forces, if you're going to be out there and if you're going to have people out there who are going to escalate the situation and you're not going to do anything to stop them, if you're going to let their negativity influence your light and have you use your light to throw at their what they tell you is the enemy, just be sure that you strategize, that you plan. Redistribute your resources. Resources are the most important things during moments like this. Not the money, the resources. So take back the resources because they're not listening to you. So you can keep marching on to the front line, but if you don't have a plan for what to do next or not, then what are you doing? Y'all better be going up to the White House with some motherfucking plans. Or else why y'all ain't take the building yet? Which y'all want to stage a coup? Y'all could have been done that. It's just the White House. Everybody swarm the White House. But y'all realize that that's not the problem. That's why it hasn't happened yet, because y'all realize that's not the problem. But you don't see what the actual problem is, so you're just lashing out. I understand. I do the same thing. I used to. I'm getting a lot better about it now. Fuck this song. I like this song. So if you're going to be out there, maintain your resources, protect your people, and stop having these punk-ass individuals just escalate the situation and you follow right behind them. If something in you tells you that something ain't right, walk away from it or stop it. Because some of y'all are out there, peaceful protesters, wishing for something better and seeing how things are being escalated. You see it. You gonna still be peaceful even though you see it? Y'all motherfuckers drive a nigga to smoke and drink. And I'm trying to take care of my body. Take care of your body. Flesh is fleeting, but you're still a gift. The humans are so damn fragile. Anyway, be careful out there if this is what you guys are choosing. Strategize, plan, and organize. If you're not organized, if you don't know where you're going next, if you don't know what the end is, if you don't know what the end is, then what the fuck is you doing? But y'all building momentum because y'all got the rest of the world hyped up. Because they waiting to see where this is gonna go. And I'm rooting for y'all too. I know bullshit when I see it.